should always be ready for the hurricane season. We must always be ready for those 6 months of the year.
Do you know the months he's referring to? Well, if you said June to November, you're absolutely right. Here's another question. How prepared are you for a hurricane? Consider your answer as we turn the pages of Jamaica Magazine. I'm Adrian Atkinson, and today I'll share some vital information on hurricane preparedness. I'll also share excerpts from a recent meeting of disaster officials who provided an update on the country's disaster preparedness plan. Plus, a few things you should know as we observe National Environmental Awareness Week. We kick things off with a stop at the news desk.
Good day, I'm Andrea Chisholm, and this is your JIS News for Thursday, June 5. Cabinet has signed off on the terms of reference for the recently established Electricity Sector Enterprise Team, ESET. Prime Minister Portia Simpson-Miller told Parliament on Wednesday that the team should lead and manage the procurement process for new electricity generating capacity in consultation with the Office of Utilities Regulation, the Jamaica Public Service, and Energy Minister Philip Polwell.
And is expected to manage the implementation of a comprehensive program to urgently replace the baseload generation with a more efficient plant, utilizing low-cost fuel in order to ensure that electricity is reliably provided to Jamaicans at affordable rates.
A release from the Office of the Prime Minister also indicated that the enterprise team should also review the current policy for the procurement of additional baseload generation and recommend possible changes to the policy. The Energy Minister should also be advised on the terms of the license or licenses to be issued. The six-member team, chaired by Dr. Vincent Lawrence, should also perform a quick assessment of the electricity sector and develop a short-term action plan to reduce electricity costs while diversifying the fuel mix. The National Housing Trust, NHT, is on track to complete over 2,000 housing solutions during this financial year. Minister with Responsibility for Housing, Dr. Morris Guy, gave an update during his sectoral presentation to Parliament on Wednesday.
Mr. Speaker, this financial year, despite the economic challenges, the NHT will be disbursing over 22.4 billion on construction and mortgage financing activities so that more of our people can have a place to call their home.
In the 2013-2014 financial year, the NHT disbursed over 7,500 construction and mortgage financing loans to the tune of $22 billion. The Petrocaribe Development Fund has set aside $18 million to assist landowners in receiving titles through the Land Administration and Management Program, LAMP. The money will assist those who are unable to complete the process due to lack of funding. In his sectoral presentation to Parliament on Tuesday, Portfolio Minister Robert Pickersgill said 62 files were already submitted for processing. The minister also indicated that $20 million was allocated to fund the operations of the adjudication committees in 9 parishes. The committees will assist persons in getting their land titles. The Ministry of Foreign Affairs and Foreign Trade has commenced preparations for the 6th Biennial Diaspora Conference from June 14 to 18, 2015. The focus of next year's conference will be trade and investment. State Minister in the Ministry of Foreign Affairs and Foreign Trade, Arnaldo Brown, says an implementation council has been established to build on the progress made at the 2013 Diaspora Conference.
Significant work has been done in terms of distilling the rapporteur's report and fleshing out an implementation schedule. Further refinement of that work continues now with JAMPRO working to distill it even further.
In the meantime, the state minister said the international migration development policy was 90% complete and the diaspora database should be unveiled at next year's conference. And finally, the health ministry will be better able to provide quality health care for patients following a donation of medical supplies valued at $600,000. The medical supplies, consisting of surgical tools and medications, will be distributed to the Kingston Public, Cornwall Regional and St. Anne's Bay hospitals. Health Minister Dr. Fenton Ferguson welcomed the donation from Senior Pastor of the Perfecting Faith Church in the United States, Donnie McClurking.
In fact, it is this kind of partnership that we have for a long time recognized as significant.
In 2012, the health sector received donations totaling $637,000 from 172 medical missions visiting the island. In 2013, donations totaling $990,000 were received from 197 missions. And that's it for GIS News Today. I'm Anja Chisholm. Thank you for watching. Prevent overfishing. Give our marine resources room to replenish. Protect valuable marine species from extinction. Fish sanctuaries have been created to do just that. These designated protected areas for fish and other marine life help to breed, grow, and maintain a healthy population. No one is allowed in a fish sanctuary. It is illegal. Offenders will be arrested and their fishing equipment and catch confiscated. Allowing our marine and seafood population to grow means more catch later and food security for all.
Earlier this week, the Office of Disaster Preparedness and Emergency Management, along with other state entities and agencies, launched the country's plan of action for the 2014 Atlantic hurricane season. AdPem also provided a status report on Jamaica's preparedness and gave timely reminders. The JIS attended the event and our team pulled a few excerpts to bring you up to speed. First up, the Meteorological Service reminds us of the hazards more common to Jamaica. As you watch, check to see which ones could affect you.
The impacts from tropical storms and hurricanes are not limited to coastal areas. When we speak about hurricanes, we seem to think that they are the hazard. But in my opinion, I haven't heard many people say this, but my opinion is a hurricane is a complexity of hazards, and there are actually four separate hazards that would affect us here in Jamaica. One of them is the very strong winds that we could encounter. The second is the very heavy rainfall. The third is the landslide effect that we would also experience quite often in Jamaica. And the fourth of these is the coastal flooding or the storm surge flooding, which is something that we tend to ignore quite often as we look into the hurricane season. And all four will actually impact on different areas of the country in different ways. Of course, the storm surge hazard would affect the coastline areas, but stronger winds would normally be experienced in higher elevations. So on the interior of the island where we have the hills, that's where we expect the winds to be more intense. We just want to add a reminder here that 116 is the number to remember during the hurricane season. 116. You can dial that number from any landline or any cellular telephone, whether it is one lime or it is Digicel. But 116 is the number to call to get the latest update on the hurricane. Any kind of news release that has been issued, the updates on hurricane activity. So we would ensure that that is updated. Rest assured that the Meteorological Service is monitoring. We monitor 24 hours per day and every day of the year, not just in the hurricane season. But in this season, of course, there's a greater alertness to any development that takes place in the Caribbean region, the Gulf of Mexico, North Atlantic Ocean, and so we are prepared. We have the experience, we have the expertise, we have the equipment to ensure that Jamaicans are kept abreast of what is happening.
Finger licking jerk chicken, Helsha fish and bami. We run down yam and banana, roast bread fruit, sweet potato pudding. Jamaica food sweet. So let's make a pledge to use more local produce and less foreign goods. Let's grow what we eat and eat what we grow.
I hope you took the time to assess where you live and take steps to ensure your safety. We now continue with another excerpt from AdPem's launch, this time from the local government minister, Noel Arscott, who spoke of drain cleaning activities so far this year.
The local authorities, that is to say the parish councils, are one of our first responders. They have already started to clean drains in many communities from as far back as April. To date, councils have expended in the region of $150 million to clean drains, and the ministry is proposing to provide the first additional top up of $50 million to assist. We're also planning to have some funds available to NSWMA to deal with the critical areas where we know that plastic bottles, which is a scourge upon the land, and plastic bags, which is really a big problem that the country faces, and we have to collectively find a solution to this problem, we'll be able to at least remove some of those from our waterways.
We have received $50 million through the normal budget to assist with the mitigation effort this year. We have divided this small sum. We have regions like Percy, so we have the Southeast region. Kingston, we are going to be spending $20 million. Kingston, St. Andrew, St. Thomas, St. Catherine. In the South, which is Clarendon, Manchester, St. Elizabeth, we're spending 10. So too in the Northeast, St. Mary, Portland, St. Anne, and in the West, Hanover, Trelawney, St. James, and Westmoreland. Now, these activities will be starting by the end of this week. The instructions have gone out to the parish teams to commence the activities. And so when you drive around the country over the next couple of weeks, you should be seeing activities, drain cleaning, mostly taking place throughout the island. We intend to have these activities wrapped up within a month of them starting. So we should be finished with the $50 million program by the end of June.
Collecting the debris might take over a month. Even the last time we were doing 3 months, I think, we were still collecting some. But that's a reality, folks. And we have to deal with the MSW first and foremost. So citizens within the country should know you can cut up, but keep it inside. Don't put it outside your gate. We at the NSW will now announce when we are coming into your area to collect. And then we expect you to put it out. On standby throughout the corporate area, St. Catherine and St. Thomas, there are many guys with trucks. So we incorporate them, you know, doing the proper guidelines, writing up. We get them on standby. We have equipment on standby. That's front-end loaders, backhoe. We have cane grabbers on standby.
Clean up the place, that's what we Understand. Productivity is the way to go for all us Jamaicans. Small business, big business, old and young, we are tell every woman and man. We want growth and prosperity, free a better nation with a building plan. So we can build our product and sell our product and put more money in our hand. Our economy can rise to a level and build a better nation. Productivity, to move forward on this land. Productivity, that's the way to go, we should understand. Productivity, to move forward on this land. Productivity, that's the way to go, we should understand. Productivity.
Productivity, pathway to prosperity. A message brought to you by the Jamaica Productivity Center, a department of the Ministry of Labor and Social Security.
Whenever there is a disaster of any kind, our economy is impacted, so the government is taking a holistic approach to ensure the readiness of the country. Acting Director General of ODPEM, Richard Thompson, reminds us now of the economic impact and the measures being taken to cushion any possible effects.
We don't have to have major events to have significant impact in country. And one event can almost wipe out an entire economy. Over the past 10 years, we have been talking about annual damage of $14 billion. And I think what we have been taking into account is mainly the infrastructural damages and damages within sector, like the agricultural sector, housing, tourism. The country grew between 1951 and probably 1980 when we have Hurricane Allen, and probably another growth beyond that up to 1988 to Gilbert. So you can see that disaster events do retard economic growth and development. And when you look in the Caribbean, and especially for Jamaica, for the past 25 years, we have been affected by Gilbert, Ivan, Dean, Tropical Storm, Gustav, Half a Storm, Nicole, and Hurricane Sandy in 2012. And we have also had localized rainfall events that have caused significant damages. So apart from hydrometeorological events, we're also affected by seismic events. And internationally, we have, on average, 8,000 seismic-related events per day. Of that international average, Jamaica have roughly over 200 per day. So we know that we have to place significant work as it relates to our seismic readiness, and we have been doing a lot of work in that area. We had a seismic workshop January, and we have launched a roadmap as it relates to our seismic readiness. The earthquake unit is doing significant research as well in that area, so it can actually speak to and inform our risk mapping. So we have been working on a number of initiatives. We have been doing a lot of work in the communities under our Building Disaster Resilience Communities project. We have done a lot of work as it relates to emergency telecommunication. We will boast proudly about the work that we have done with one of our at-risk population, which is the persons with disability. So we have actually come a very far way in terms of our disaster risk reduction programs in country. We have moved from an area where we look at disaster risk response to disaster risk reduction. So we're looking at comprehensive disaster management. We look at all hazards, from your anthropogenic, your man-made type events, your chemical event. We have doing a lot of plan development, looking at our search and rescue plan, looking at our chemical response plan. So we have done significant work in that area, because the ultimate component of our mandate is to ensure that we have a safe and resilient Jamaica.
A message from the Keep Jamaica Clean Committee, supported by the Chase Fund.
The wetlands are the home for animals and trees, that's why we beg you, protect them, please. Una may look at them as dirty water, but the trees in them help in disaster. The mangrove tree prevents soil erosion, and it also prevents soil from forming land. The wetlands are also tourist attraction. When the white man got it, he might say,
yeah, man.
Protect them, preserve them, not destroy them. When we do it, we are destroyed with future, my friend. To NEPA, JT and other agency, continue with all your advocacy. We will also help you continue to preach. One day, we know the max will reach.
Youngsters spreading the message of the consequences of our actions on the environment. And government continues to build that awareness through the work of the Urban Development Corporation.
In 1968, the Urban Development Corporation, UDC, was established by an Act of Parliament to facilitate planned and orderly development when and where it was needed in the country. Since its inception, the corporation has made an integral contribution to the development of many sectors. Over the years, the UDC has implemented its environmental management responsibility through programs such as water quality monitoring, ecological assessments, environmental audits, and protected area management in UDC-designated areas. Routine water quality monitoring is conducted at all UDC attractions on a regular basis to determine if a stream, the ocean, or coastal water is good enough to support the purpose for which it is being used. These tests are guided by existing local and international standards. The UDC conducts both land and marine-based ecological assessments. These are done in forests, rivers, and streams. An ecological assessment is a comprehensive description of the natural resources in an area. The assessment involves all living things within the environment. Several years ago, the UDC implemented measures to conduct environmental audits. The aim of this audit is to ensure that all activities at UDC operating facilities comply with best environmental practices and legislation. These audits are usually done biannually. Once all the information is compiled, it is used to guide the development process as well as the management of UDC designated areas. The UDC also engages in protected area management. This was formalized in 1999 when the UDC designated area of Helsher Hills and Goat Islands, which forms part of Portland Bight, was declared a protected area. Following this declaration, the UDC was delegated management authority by NEPA to ensure that all the species and ecosystems within Helsher are protected. The environmental team at UDC does more than implement management programs. Once an idea is conceptualized, the team assesses and advises on environmentally friendly projects that can be conducted in the designated areas. The team plays a crucial role in the entire process of planning, design, implementation of a project, or operation of a facility. The corporation also implements public education campaigns and activities geared towards informing the public about the importance of protecting the environment. The UDC, making development happen in the Jamaican environment.
To learn more about the work of the Urban Development Corporation, call 922-831024 or visit their website at www.udcja.com. You may also follow them on Facebook, YouTube and Twitter, or visit their information center on the ground floor, Kingston Mall, downtown Kingston.
Urban Scope was brought to you by the Urban Development Corporation in association with the Jamaica Information Service.
It's a new beginning.
New day is dawning. It's time to arise. We are the gene of achievement and pride.
Bold new beginning, time for action. We have the spirit to fight on.
This is Jamaica, this is our land. We have our future with God in our plan. We'll play our part building this great nation. This is Jamaica, this is our land.
Let us make every effort to forge unity.
Yeah.
I resolve to work hard for our prosperity.
Leaving our children a legacy of hope. Breaking the shackles and smashing the yoke.
This is Jamaica.
This is Jamaica.
This is our land.
This is our
land. We have our future with God in our plan.
Together we can.
As we use the month of June to reinforce disaster preparedness measures for hurricanes, earthquakes, landslides, fires, and floods, let's all take the time to educate ourselves and build our resilience level. We say so long for now, until tomorrow, when we do it all over again. We ask that you stay connected via our website, jis.gov.jm. And while you're on the web, send your ideas and comments via Twitter at JIS News or email jamaicamagazine@jis.gov.jm. On behalf of the entire production crew, I'm Adrian Atkinson. Walk good and stay safe.
This has been a production of the Jamaica Information Service, the voice of Jamaica.